Okay, well, that was an awesome panel. I'm glad we got to add a few more minutes to that. And thank you all the speakers, all the panelists, all the patient advocates, all the patients, all the people that helped made today what it was. It's a fantastic conference, and thank you all for sticking it through to the end. So we really appreciate you all being a part of the event. The 6th Annual Clinical Trials Summit is now coming to a close. We hope that next year we'll be in person, or you know, maybe we'll have some VR goggles and we can all shake hands virtually, something like that. But I'd like to quickly make some acknowledgments for the people that have had to listen to my bad jokes that in March transitioned over to dad jokes. So for every week we had a phone call planning this event from early March, and it was not so easy aiming at a moving target, figuring out when we were going to do this, how we were going to do this. So a lot of hard work went into putting this together and identifying a platform, identifying all the wonderful speakers and voices that we heard today. So specific thanks goes out to Martha Hasselbeck and Kathy Florek, Melanie Wobblehorse, Candace Howell, Sharon Hanlon, who's support and has allowed us to continue to partner with BMS on this event. And last but not least, Lorena Curie, who's on the call right now also. And thank you guys all so much. This was a great event. Please make sure to submit all of your questions, and there'll be networking on the one-on-one networking tab up until 5 o'clock today. So make sure to take advantage of all those opportunities. And with that, I'll leave it to Lorena.
Thank you, Doug. Thank you very much. And I would say that the very big thank you goes as well to you, to the Panagora team, because they allowed BMS to host virtually this time this event, and we are very happy to do so. And to the Axel Events team and Carson O'Shaughnessy, who behind the scene has been also working diligently these past weeks. So I will try to be, I would say, brief, but better said, direct to the point, because wow, what a day we had today. I am lucky that I am not in my basement locked anymore. I sent my kids down, but I was able to listen into all of the sessions. And I was super happy since we started understanding that we were having people from all around the world joining us today. And then just listening to the three things that Kate highlighted as words that she considers to be part of a clinical trial, super important, when she mentioned care, courage, and commitment. And we connected them immediately with Marla Jan Wexler. Wow, what an example. I would say that her message about therapeutic communication is super important, and that there is not too much communication was fundamental as we learn more about why words matter and the importance of being like communicating in a clinical trial. And then going to David Leventhal's presentation on the meaningful closure. I would say that's what I'm going to be trying to do right now. I know everyone is waiting to go and do their second shift at home or other things, but this closure is important for the patient, for the site, and for the advocacy organization. And it's the meaning of gratitude what really counts on that. So that was very, very close to me, because I think the more that we partner, the better that we will be improving the journey of patients in clinical trials. And going back to the collaboration that Helen fostered when she was hosting the partnering with advocacy groups, it was perfect that she reminded us the words from Ruth Bader Ginsburg about fight for the things that you care about, but do it in a way that we will lead others to join us. I would say that the close to 200 people that we have today here are in this together, and we're holding hands to make sure that this happens. So thank you, Sue Friedman, for talking about the importance on health literacy. I need to confirm, I need to be honest, I needed to double check what jargon meant. So it is important that we do it right. Deanne, thank you for talking about digital patient engagement and bringing the example and the simple sentence of we had the right data, but the wrong demographics. Let's make sure that we work on that and we get the right demographics, because it cares. Thank you, Catherine Soto, for talking about the awareness. And Brian from Spark Cures, I love when you say that it was not about recruitment, but relationships. And as Helen closed up saying, it's about sustainability and meaningful connections. So very, very good sessions. Then we went to everything that Karen McIntyre and Anna were sharing about seniors and how ACRS have been seeing the evolution from COVID. I would say that now we have been exposed to a new way of working, but this new way of working brought some disruptions that made us evolve. So let's make sure that we keep those disruptions in our memory and we keep this evolution going and we get ready for the challenges that will be coming, because I'm sure that the new challenges will be harder than COVID. So kudos to all the things that sites are doing and how CROs are working together. Wow, the session from Trevor Maxwell and Man Up to Cancer, I would say I have never thought about it, but really, really meaningful. Mental health, relationships, and the relation with medical outcomes are super important. And it's not about the message itself, but it's also about the messenger. Thank you for bringing us to the memory that isolation is not something that patients should go through. And brings me back to the power of the collective and the value of collaboration and allies and education. Again, to the humongous learnings that we had during the day. I would say that it's all bringing this conversation together.
Yep.
I will also say that I enjoyed Samit and Richard speaking up what pharma is trying to do, like working with the entire healthcare ecosystem to address or to work towards patient centricity, true patient centricity. And then the panel with Professor Mesa, Cassandra, Dan, and Roslyn, I would say that's fantastic. You know, as head of diversity strategy, that is my full-time job, but that is also right. very close to my heart.
For sure.
So I was impressed on how perfectly the interactions between them fit, because it talked about the scientific need, what the ecosystem is trying to do and how the sites were working, and the relevance that community outreach has.
Well, Lorena, you deserve a lot of credit for spearheading and being the brain trust on that panel. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's why it came together the way it did.
It was very good. But the entire day, really, it was very, very good. And then when Alison presented to us how decentralized clinical trials are coming together around the world, what can we do? How can we make sure that we keep these learnings and we progress? And we just by providing tools that patients need, we make their journeys easier. And then the last session with Hassan and Kelly, Craig and Craig as well, very interesting, because we need to understand that we can't continue doing the same thing and expecting different outcomes, right? Unless we are all crazy.
Insanity, right?
Yes, unless we're all crazy. And kudos for Kelly and for Craig for signing into a COVID trial. I think that's great. I also am making my part. I'm trying to support the inclusion of Latin representation in COVID trials. So hopefully that works and we find a solution all together. And that brings me to my final comments. You know, our mission at BMS is to connect and inspire global teams as we continue to transform patients' lives through science. But I am sure that everyone, no matter which role they're having within BMS or outside BMS, in a patient advocacy group organization, in a site, in a clinic, in a hospital, we are all working for patients. So like the African proverb says, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. The thing is that we need to go fast and we need to go far. So let's hold hands and just make sure that we keep on working these, because I know that all of us are trying to become the most inclusive patient-centric companies and provide patients what they really need, when they really need it, and how they really need it.
Absolutely. That's so very well said, Lorena.
I did my notes. It's been
a pleasure working with you and Candace and Martha and Melanie and the whole team. So thank you so much for all of your support. And we're looking forward to planning next year in person. So absolutely. Let's plan on that. And thank you to all the advocates and everyone who chimed in on the chat platform. A lot of the best questions that came from the day came right from crowdsourcing. So thank you so much. And everyone enjoy the networking function, enjoy the last break. And next year, maybe we'll do it with an adult beverage, but enjoy the virtual networking. And thank you again so much.
Thank you.
All right. Take care, Lorena. Bye-bye.